I just want to know about the concept of Amada. Am I pronouncing that right?
Yes, Amada.
Yeah, tell me about that. Because for instance, in the Christian religions or other religious orders and other religious cultures, you always have a omnipresent a deity or something like that that you go to. For instance, American Indians would say the Great Mystery. You know, Christians might say God, Islam, Allah, you know, Yahweh, whatever. The Hebrews, so what? You know, or for that matter, the Rastas will say. Okay.
Yeah. No. Basically, Kamata it's a Xhosa. Xhosa word referring to God. That's how Xhosas refer to God. I mean, it's a traditional Xhosa word referring to God.
And I understand the word, but I'm actually trying to figure out the concept, because what I understand is not the same. That's what I'm trying to say. Is the concept the same, or are you saying it is the same?
No, the concept of understanding Kamata is more or less the same as how, for instance, the Israelites understand their God, Yahweh. So the concept of Kamata is God who is believed to be everywhere, who brings about prosperity, peace, and all the things that a nation would want for it, you know, to prosper and be successful.
But in my research, I've come across something different. It would be like Kamata would be almost like a connecting source. In other words, beyond the answer, to get this Kamata, you have to go through the ancestors. Yeah. That's why you have the ancestor worship or whatever have you. But even with that, Kamata has to do with connecting things rather than administrating to things, or like some deity looking down on you. Of course, the concept of Kamata leaves out the concept of heaven and hell, for instance.
Yeah.
Is this true?
Yeah, that is very true. You know, it's very difficult, to be honest, you know, to give you a precise answer on this, because we, for quite a lengthy time, were not allowed to understand God the way we should as Africans. So our understanding of our God is distorted. So I think there is a need for us to learn more about how we understand God, our concepts, our understanding of the concepts of God. But basically, what you're saying is true. You as Africans, as we understand Kamata is, you know, this concept of heaven and earth, for instance, does not really exist. Kamata is this force, you know, which is connecting all, you know, we are connected, nature is one. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we understand when we communicate through our ancestors to Kamata, we actually communicate our wishes, whatever that we want to communicate, you know, to nature. To something which is above the humanity or the human ability to comprehend everything which is surrounding us.
But one of the things about this is that, for instance, if we stay with the Judeo-Christian ethics, basically, just basically talk about Christians and say Islam, other things, is that in those religions, let's say when the missionaries came here, they would have a concept of heaven and hell, which basically means heaven would be almost like the hope, and hell would be the fear. So if you would fear going to heaven, or rather you would fear going to hell and hope that you would go to heaven. And so you have that dynamic playing off, and that's more or less, it's not in contradiction to Kamata. It's just a different concept. But and I've noticed a lot of Africans hold both of these concepts. Can you talk about that?
Yeah, of course. I mean, I said it earlier on that our understanding of God is been distorted since the arrival of you know, the colonizers in this part of the world, like in Africa. So, for instance, I'm 34 years old now. I still try very hard to understand myself so that I can understand my God. I can only understand my God when I understand myself and I understand my ancestors. So those things are connected. At the moment, there is a lot of distortion around those things which make up me. You get my point? So I can't give you a precise answer to say this is how I understand where you're coming from. But at this particular point in time, it would be very difficult for me to say this is how things should be, because they believe there's a lot of perhaps maybe talk consultations that have to be conducted, talking with the elder in our communities and all that kind of stuff. So there's a lot, but the primary thing I think which is important at this particular point is that I'm in the process of finding myself. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, in that process, I suppose now you are a student at the University of Fort Hare here in Eastern Cape in the Republic of South Africa. Tell us your name and what your course of study is.
Well, my name is Mzomato Dapongolo. I was born in King Williamstown. I'm a student at Fort Hare. I'm doing theology, majoring in ethics and systematic theology, and this is my second year.
When you say second year, I mean
second year of my master's.
Yeah. Oh, it's a master. Okay, yeah. It's a postgraduate.
Yeah, postgraduate. Yeah, mm-hmm. Postgraduate. Yes.
Okay. All right. Thank you so very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.